Hi everybody, Jesse here. Thank you for joining me. It is Sunday the 11th, is it? And I've got some special news. I've got a big announcement. I'm offering a special deal. I've teamed up with the people at godless.com and we're offering a special sale that you're not going to get anywhere else. If you don't know, Godless is a really cool site where you can get ebook copies of horror books. And they offer a lot of stuff that you can't get anywhere else, like extreme horror, indie horror, stuff that Amazon would ban, for instance. So you can get stuff like that, and you can get it at discounted deals that you wouldn't get anywhere else. So today, I'm offering an exclusive deal that you're not going to get anywhere else. First of all, the price on all of my books on Godless has gone down. It was $5.99, now it is $2.99. You can get any one of my books for just $2.99. But for this week only, from the 11th to the 18th of July, if you get one of my two novels, either Lady of the Lake or Skinner, you will also get a collection of tales for free. This is my collection of short stories. There's 13 short stories here, all spooky, ghastly, disgusting stuff that hopefully horror fans are gonna love. So yeah, if you get Skinner or Lady of the Lake for just $2.99, you get a copy of this for free, an ebook copy. And that's an exclusive. You can't find that anywhere else other than godless.com. So I put the link down in the description. Check that out. Now, on to the other topic of today's episode. I was thinking about what I'm going to talk about, and something occurred on Facebook that I feel like I need to talk about. I think a lot of my inspiration for this show comes from things that happened to me on Facebook, right? So there's this person on Facebook who I'm not going to name because I'm not trying to like start a war with this person, and I hold nothing against this person. But this is someone, and a lot of you are going to know who I'm talking about, so I'm not going to name him. But this is somebody who kind of famously embraces the title of being a troll. You know, he kind of makes himself like the heel in wrestling, where in professional wrestling, there has to be a heel, there has to be a bad guy, and this guy likes being a bad guy. And he will troll you, and he will talk shit, and he likes to push people's buttons, and especially authors, indie authors, and try to break them down and make them feel like they're worthless. And I've never had a problem with him until the last couple days. And I've actually, you know, made it a point that, you know, this stuff doesn't bother me. What he does, I don't take personally, and I don't mind if he's gonna like talk trash to people. And but then he started doing it to me. And here's the thing, you know, I did release another video a couple months ago about the art of taking criticism. And I said some things that I will stand by. And one of those things is that you have to be ready to accept criticism. If your work is going out to the public, you gotta be ready for people to critique you, to tell you what they think. And it can be harsh sometimes, right? But then what I'm talking about today is not the art of taking criticism, but the art of giving it. Because while people can, you know, feel free to give their criticism, you know, there's a way of going about it. There's a way of talking to people. And I have always been cool with this guy. I've never given him any shit. Everyone else on Facebook likes to trash him and, you know, slam his name and block him and unfriend him and tell him he's a piece of trash. And they can do that, but I've always defended this guy. And I've always been cool with him. And then It kind of culminated yesterday, but he's been talking some smack about me, the way that he's talked about others. And he's coming at me with like, well, you know, your books aren't edited very well. You know, I've read the first chapter of your books on Amazon, and they're really not edited very well. And I was like, okay. Like, I'm willing to listen to whatever feedback you have, you know. But he never would give me any feedback. He would just say, like, your editors did a terrible job, you know. And yesterday I posted something about, you know, I wrote like 4,500 words yesterday. That was a good day for me, you know. I'm happy with myself. And he posts, well, I hope you have a good editor. And I said, yes, I have two new editors. And he says, well, if they had anything to do with the books that you released already, I'm sure they suck. They don't know what they're doing and all this. And what it comes down to is he wasn't offering me anything constructive. You know, he wasn't being specific, and he wasn't being constructive. It was basically like a schoolyard taunt, like, you suck, you're not very good. Or he'd say things like, hey, you're an okay writer for an amateur. And one of the things he said was, you're an artist, sort of. It's like, you know, I've been an artist all my life, but he says, you're an artist, sort of. And I mean, I'm not going to say everything that he said throughout the course of this thread, but everything was just like, you know, you don't know as much as you think you know about writing. You'll never know as much as I know, you know, all this kind of stuff. And it was basically just personal attacks and being rude, really. He wasn't being constructive at all. And even when someone else would come in, someone who didn't say anything to him, wasn't being rude to him at all, this one person said, you know, excited to see what you have. You know, excited to see what you're writing. And he would comment to them saying something like, yay for incomplete sentences. And it's like, man, this person didn't say anything to you. You know, why do you have to go after them? You know, it's like, I'm open to criticism. If you wanna criticize me or my work, tell me, like, okay, I read your book, or I read the first chapter, and I found this, this, and this wrong. You know, you have certain grammatical mistakes you keep repeating. The way that your characters speak is not realistic. You know, give me some specifics to work with, not just your writing isn't very good kind of thing. You know, and like, this is what I do. Like, I read somebody's book that I met off Facebook, and this was someone that seemed like a cool person, and I liked the title of their book, and I liked the cover of their book, so I bought the book, and I read it. And I enjoyed the book, but I also found some issues with it. There were some grammatical issues, there were some narrative issues, but I didn't go after this person publicly online. You know, publicly, I wrote a good review, I listed everything that I liked about the book, but then privately, I DM'd him and said, hey, you know, this is, all the stuff that I posted is true. I really did like all that stuff about your book. But now, let me just say, these are the things that, you know, I did find distracting. There were some grammatical issues. I felt like there needed to be more urgency during some of the action scenes. I felt like some of the exchanges between the people, like the characters weren't behaving the way people would behave in that kind of situation. You know, I gave him some specifics, and I was polite about it. And if you're a friend of someone, or even a Facebook acquaintance, that's how you should behave. Because if you're going to call yourself an editor, and if you're going to critique people's work, you know, you got to know how to talk to people. And being an editor is not just about knowing your grammar and being right about the technical aspect of writing. It's about working with people. You know, and if you can't talk to people, you can't work with people, no one's going to want to work with you. No one's going to want to refer you to their friends if their friends need an editor. You know, it's not the way to effectively get across what you're trying to say and effectively help someone. It's essentially just being rude and mean-spirited, and it's an egotistical thing coming from you, right? So am I bothered by it? Am I hurt by it? No. I've gotten some good feedback from people, and I've gotten some good constructive responses from people. And like I said, I'm not trying to start a war with this guy. I've got no problem with him. I'm not going to talk shit about him or mention his name or anything like that. But that's not how I roll. That's not how I take criticism. I'm going to speak to you with respect, and I expect to be respected in return. So that's how you want to give critique to people. That's how I do it. That's how I expect it to be done. So that's all I got for today. Remember, godless.com, 1 week. Today's the 11th. Next Sunday is the 18th. You've got 1 week by either Skinner or Lady of the Lake for $2.99, and you get a collection of tales for free. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it.